Hi, welcome to Conversations at Jazz. This is Aisha Sarwari, Head of Communications and Sustainability at Jazz. We have a wonderful episode here today talking about how digital links to regulatory, digital policy, media, and the law. We have wonderful guests here with us today whose bio you see underneath their names, and they need no introduction, really. I'll start right off with Fahd. Fahd, how does the route to digitalization affect content?
The way that digitalization is happening is having a very direct impact on content. Now, I think that impact is not visible as much as, you know, it's actually making a difference.
Can you give us an example, because you also do digital content, what are the things that people ask you to talk about?
So, for example, if you look at, if you were to look at some social media platform, you know, whether it's Facebook or whether it's Twitter, and then you look at the content on our mainstream television, and let me focus on the news media. And if you look at the content, you will see a difference. The variety that you see on social media is not there on television. The reason is that because in social media, everybody is giving his or her opinion, they're picking out issues that they feel strongly about.
Salman, you've done several landmark cases when it comes to getting the country in terms of its business readiness. What do you see as some of the essential things that could be missing or are being done right when it comes to ease of doing business, particularly with telco and ICT?
Obviously, whether you are in an electronic media hitting the airwaves or you're a digital platform, you are now being made to suffer, as if it were, for the content that you put out much more than in the past. But I see the digital platforms, whether it's Twitter or whatever, Facebook, as escaping this prior restraint problem, because it's still not possible to restrain somebody from tweeting whatever they will tweet. So there's going to be this interaction between the various platforms standing for the right of free speech and their need to do business and to engage with the government, with the authorities, and get various licenses and permissions and so on.
So if you were to advise any ICT organization or the ecosystem as a whole on how to proceed to help the regulatory community understand the business impact?
I think the various entities and individuals involved in this sector have to come together and have to take a position on the right to speech and articulate it with greater vigor and not just let the state lay down the parameters all the way.
Ali, can you help explain what the policy perspective is for ICT industry as a whole?
I think the number one starter for pursuing the digital agenda in Pakistan now, there has to be a convergence of policy, convergence of regulatory bodies that look at digitalization as a unique, holistic product. So I genuinely believe that if digitalization has to progress in Pakistan, the policymaking environment has to be looked at almost from scratch, or if not from scratch, a 2.0 version, as we're talking digital, that resets the clock to take that imperative into account.
So Salman, if I can bring you in, I think we kind of missed going over the first part of the question that I asked you. Your landmark, sort of legal work has surrounded on making Pakistan better in terms of ease of business, you know?
So I think we need to emphasize that some norms have to be upheld regardless of content, regardless of leaning of a particular platform. But that's a more fundamental battle. That is about really creating democratic space, creating respect for various rights and so on.
What game-changing legislation can change that?
So things have improved clearly. So these codes and manuals are now available online. They get updated fairly regularly and so on. So to that extent, I would say we are probably a better regulatory state than we were 10, 15, 20 years ago. And there is a realization that change in policy or abrupt changes in policy are disruptive.
What are some of the leapfrogging things that perhaps the organization and the industry is doing that you really like? I think you've had a positive override.
You know, everyone in this room,
except
included,
me.
Possibly. Yeah. We're digital immigrants. We've learned to become comfortable with technology. We don't think digital, whereas our children certainly think digital. And I think that's that group of people who are now at levels where they're either running companies or doing businesses, that critical mass will now start to become a force for the good, and I think we'll start to make those challenges a lot more that I've been talking about. Government has to sit up and take notice. There is no other way.
Your last words on one thing you would change?
I think, you know, if I speak in terms of, you know, what I do, news and television and content generation, I think if the potential of Pakistanis was unleashed just to produce and become their own citizen journalists. We have too few narratives between the government and the mainstream media. And if you know, individuals or small groups can actually come in with certain formulas for revenue generation, I think sky is the limit.
So, Salman, how does Pakistan reach that tipping point? And I think in your case, particularly legally or regulatory, how do you ensure that the powerful don't come in the way?
So what I see at the moment is a population that hasn't really come to grips with this phenomenon. And the fact that, you know, when people are self-publishing without editorial control, there will be all kinds of things put out. I don't see that wisdom at play at the moment, because we're really reacting as if this is, you know, a front that has been opened and we need to just hit back with all the might that we can muster. But over time, we need to start relaxing about all this and start taking this in our stride.
Ali, from a tech standpoint, the big idea, no resource crunch, no fear. Say you had like an army of media and legal to support you, what would you do?
I'm going to say that if there's one thing I could do, it would be near digital Pakistan. I don't think there can be a near Pakistan without a digital Pakistan. And I think Salman referred to it. Enough people start to talk about it, challenge it, fight for it, speak for it, it will bring about a difference, I'm convinced.
On that note, thank you so much for watching this, and thank you to Fahd, Salman and Ali for sharing your thoughts.